My name is Adriana Bravo, and I'm a PhD student at Louisiana State University. I'm participating in this rapid inventory with the large and small mammal groups, and basically what we have to do is complete a quick census to find evidence of the presence of mammals. If we're able to observe an actual mammal live in the field, this is optimal. If not, we look for tracks or holes where a mammal like an armadillo or a giant anteater might sleep. And also the idea is to try and walk through the habitats ranging in size from about 1 kilometer, more or less. Sometimes it takes more time to view certain habitats. We also do nocturnal walks, and if time permits, and depending on weather, we open nets to catch and record the most common species of bats. However, in this inventory we have not had very much luck. Some days it has rained too much, and now we have a spectacular moon, which isn't optimal. But we do try to do our best effort. The whole inventory team helps, because many pairs of eyes make it easier to find and identify mammals. For example, if a team member comes back from the field and describes a primate they spied, we can use identification guides and pretty much figure out what kind of primate species it is. So in fact, it is a very cooperative process. I dedicated myself exclusively to do these things, but everyone helps out. Our advanced team also helps contribute to the list. They report on what they saw when they cut the trails or established our campsite. We record what we consume, sell, hunt or don't hunt, what they do or don't find in particular habitats. All these things help to really obtain valid information of what exists in this place. This inventory is very interesting because the primates are good indicators of the presence of fruits in the forest. If you don't find many primates, you know you won't find many fruits. In Camp 1, we observed a low primate diversity that could be related to the low fruit production in the area. Flooding in the area meant fewer tracks were observed. But in Camp 2, which had an abundance of fruits, we saw many more primates, many more tapir tracks. And at Camp 3, which is also protected zone by the Cofan people, we saw the benefits of protection because there is an even higher abundance of primates and tapirs. When you speak to the people, you notice that they are a step ahead in conservation tactics. And this is noticeable when you compare it to the place or places that have not been conserved, such as Camp 4, where we observe less abundance due to the effects of hunting. And now at Camp 5, we are near a village and we see some evidence that there is hunting going on. So in general, we have observed that the more distant a site is from a village and the anthropogenic influences, such as loggers and hunting, or things like that, the greater abundance and diversity of mammals can be found.